When you send your survey by email, writing a great subject line and message is crucial for getting people to open the email and click through to take your survey. Let's go through the ins and outs of composing a great email invitation. After you add recipients, it's time to write your invitation message. First, edit the subject line. A good subject line is short, but relevant to your survey topic. For example, instead of "give us your feedback," try something more specific like "how was your experience with us?" This will give people a better idea of what the survey is about right away. If your survey starts with a multiple choice, MPS, or star rating question, you can choose to embed it directly into your email. When someone answers the question in the email, the survey will open with that answer filled in. If you'd rather not embed your first question, just click to toggle it off. It's a good idea to edit the message to explain what the survey is about, how long it takes to complete, and how you plan to use the results. And it's nice to explain that the responses are anonymous, so people know what to expect when they answer your survey. If you uploaded your recipients with custom data, like the first and last names, you can use it in your message to give your emails a more personal touch. Before you save, you can change what your header says and edit the color to match exactly with your brand. If you've not embedded your first question into your survey, you can also change the text and color of the button to begin the survey. Depending on your plan, you can also remove the SurveyMonkey footer from your email to keep things more in line with your brand. Now save and check out how your email looks on desktop and mobile. We recommend using the HTML template, but if you need to create a plain text or custom HTML email, you can do just that. A plain text email is exactly what it says on the box. An email with standard text and no fluff, like bolded words or different font sizes. To start writing a plain text email, just click Edit Message and then choose Plain Text. Just like before, you can start writing your message in the box below. You should notice some words wrapped in brackets. These are required to be in the email and contain things like the link to your survey. When you delete any of the required data, you won't be allowed to save, so make sure to include it. If you accidentally delete it or want to move it somewhere else, click Insert Required Data to quickly add it back into your message. If you're comfortable writing your own HTML, click Custom HTML to start creating your email. Bear in mind that you still need to have the required data in this email, but otherwise, the sky's the limit. You can use HTML and inline CSS to completely customize your email with images, videos, or links and change the look and feel to suit your brand. When you're done, make sure to save, and now you're ready to send your email and start collecting responses.